My name is Matthew Zabel. We're at the NIH, specifically in the National Eye Institute. Even more specifically, at the Unit on Neuronal-Glial Interactions in Retinal Disease. So right now I'm working on a group of inherited retinal degenerations that are called retinitis pigmentosa. And basically what happens, there's a mutated gene, and this results in blindness in the periphery of the retina. Well, I am the first person in my family with a doctorate. I come from Los Angeles, California. Actually, before all of this, I played college baseball at South Dakota State University, so I'm a transplant from California. Throughout my college baseball career, I decided I wanted to do something different with my life. I really enjoyed science and research. Solving problems was something I really wanted to do. Where a friend of mine was killed in an accident and had a severe brain injury. And from that point on, I wanted to basically find cures for right now incurable neurological diseases. So I started out in Alzheimer's disease, and now I'm into vision. And I do a lot of tissue dissection and preparing that tissue for visualization under a microscope. I basically stain it with really beautiful dyes, and when I look under the laser microscope, I can see everything in bright, beautiful colors. It's quite magnificent, actually. So right now, this is an image, a confocal micrograph of human tissue that's been stained to view the immune cells of the retina, and including actual retinal photoreceptors, which you can see through here. And the green marks the immune cells of the retina, which are called microglia. And right now, I'm outlining an orthogonal view where we can see microglia actually engulfing photoreceptors in this human piece of human tissue. At the present, there's no cure for any of the diseases that we're studying in this lab. And so the main point is to find out what is going on in these diseases, find out mechanisms of disease, and essentially target certain areas of the disease that will eventually lead to therapies that we can use in the clinic. As if you were to turn your camera all the way to your left, you would see a bunch of other people working on similar problems as I am, and we all have something in common, which is to find therapies for people who are ailed by these diseases. And there's constantly collaborations going on with other institutions. I'm constantly meeting and networking with new people all the time.
That's so, what we want to see the results.
Yeah.
And for the control is much smaller. Basically, I believe that's P26.
These were P26,
yeah.
I think,
so
right?
For...
I actually don't even look forward to vacations most of the time because it means I'm missing out on something in the lab. It's tough to say, but I think with the way that biomedical advances are progressing, that there someday will be cures for these diseases. And we learn new things every day, every month. There's always new papers coming out, always new findings that are giving us a little bit of a hint on how to combat these diseases. So that's the short term, is to find out what's going on. The long term would be to actually implement therapies that could cure these diseases someday. The big advice that I would say is learn to network with people. The mantra of it's not what you know, it's who you know, really means something in science, because science is about collaboration and ideas and getting people together to solve really difficult problems that pertain to humanity. And so I would say communication with other people is an interest in science, but also just communication with other people.